Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. My name is Sammy and I'm here as Track 5 Art Conversations With. And today joining me is Union Blue, which is Pete and Deb. So welcome, Pete and Deb.
Hello. And
lovely to have you join me this afternoon. This is obviously pre-recorded because it's going out at a later date. But also because you are so busy, the same time I could get you to sit still for 5 minutes. Right, so Union Blue, Pete and Deb, can you tell us a little bit more about yourself before we go further on? Just a bit of back history for both of you.
Go.
Came about through default, I think it's fair to say, in as much as we were both solo players, and then we teamed up with three other people and became a band just for one particular function that then went on, and we ended up doing a few things. And Pete and I wanted to, in a nutshell this is obviously, but Pete and I wanted to go on and do a few more gigs and be a bit, little bit more active, and the rest of the band either didn't want to or couldn't because of work commitments. And so we were like the splinter group, if you like, and we just split up and we sat around the table on one occasion with Val, Pete's wife as well, and came up with a name. And
yeah, we were both, I think it's fair to say, we were both came to performing later in life. Certainly I had never performed in bands. I've played the guitar since I was about 10, but you know, work and life gets in the way of music. It's all about earning money and keeping a roof above your head. So I'd not done anything till really later on in life when I had more time and the kids had grown up and left, and was able to devote a bit more time to honing the art, really, because you know, it's a massive thing when you go out and perform. The nerves get the better of you and you've got to overcome so many things. It's not only the technical challenge of playing the guitar and tuning your voice, but it's also about handling the nerves and being able to put on some form of performance where the audience are at ease rather than on tenterhooks waiting for you to make a mistake because you're so nervous that it comes through. So it took a while, certainly for me, to get that under my belt. And part of that process was joining little clubs and open mics and so on. There's one in particular where Debs and I first met, which was at a local arts centre called Southall Park, which is a massive resource for all sorts of, all the arts, it's fair to say. And there was a guy there who held a little session every couple of weeks where we'd all sit around in a circle and we'd play a song each and then move on. And that really gave us the confidence to build on what we knew, you know, and hone the art. And this particular guy, lovely guy, but his one aim in life was to get us all to sing without lyrics in front of us. And we have hated him, but it did us the world of good to push us in that direction. And I suppose we would have been poles apart. Nobody would have said Debs and Pete will be playing together.
No, definitely not.
You both have a different genre of music that you like. What's yours, Pete?
I like all music, seriously, all music. And I really don't like people pigeonholing. However, if I were to say one particular music, I'd say it had to be country. And that's just because of the influence of my dad when I was growing up. And that was the sort of music that was around the house. And that's what I heard. And, of course, first started to play.
And you, Debs?
Difficult to say. What I like to listen to is very easy because I'm an out-and-out rocker at heart. Heavy metal, back to the 70s, 80s, Black Sabbath, Def Leppard, Led Zeppelin, Iron Maiden, who, funny enough, I was listening to in the car just as I was driving here. But that isn't what I quite clearly like to play. don't get me wrong, if there was an opportunity to play in a rock band that played that, and I was of the level that could do it, that would be great. Mm-hmm. But that's not going to happen. That boat's long sailed. And playing wise, because I've never listened to popular music, other than when I was literally a child, a babe, when you're 7, 8, 9, 10, and mm-hmm. popular music's all you're listening to, I'm not that into pop music. I don't know a lot about it because I've only ever listened really to rock. And so playing wise, I don't, as a general rule, know that much of the run of the mill stuff, and certainly none of the modern stuff. I don't even know the artists, let alone what they, you know, it's just, you know, name a Taylor Swift song. No, I've heard of her.
We play some modern songs, but modern to us is like 20 years.
Yeah. And a lot of that is because Pete's introduced me to it, because it's not something, you know, then we make our own version of it. But it wouldn't be that I would then go off and listen to a load of that particular artist and sort of see, you know, what it's about.
And pick up there, when you say you make your own version of it, can you actually explain that? Because you do something really incredible. You're not a cover band. You do sing other people's songs, but you are definitely not a cover band. Can you just let everyone know what you, your process actually is?
I think fundamentally it's a question of obviously taking the bare bones of the original song and then seeing how you can change it, whether it's by tempo. I mean, in some cases, it might even be even deviating from the melody. But it's phrasing. I mean, it really is just reworking the song, making it our own style, rather than, as you quite rightly say, just literally covering it verbatim and just being a cover band.
It sounds really clever to do that, and it is. I mean, I'm not calling us clever, but people who take songs and change them up purposefully is a very clever thing to do. I think for me, it's born out of hearing a song and playing what I remember. And that in itself changes the song. And then you start to develop it from there. Then you start to maybe change the chords a little bit, make the sound a little bit different, play in a different position on the fretboard, which makes it sound, you know, sometimes almost oriental in some respects. So it's for me, it's sometimes about not playing it correctly in the first place, and then going from there and modifying it upwards. And then when you get two people together to do that, it more than doubles the effort. You know, you can manage to change things and change the voices, and one sing high, one sing low, one play the guitar capoed up so it's nice and high, and the other one play it down low. It's all about throwing everything you can at it to make it, or to stamp your own style on it. I think we've been described as Americana.
Mm.
And I guess it is. And you know, what's in Americana? There's a whole heap of things thrown into Americana, including folk and blues and country and everything else. And that's basically what we do. Debs plays banjo on a few of our numbers. I play a bit of harp.
Absolutely. And equally, because we both play by ear, we're not a slave to the sheet music. Mm. So we can free flow and we'll just feed off each other, and we can hear where the other one's going. So then you follow, and you're just listening the whole time, because you're playing by ear, as opposed to, as I say, having to have the sheet music in front of you, which kind of limits you in some ways, certainly in the way that we play. It limits you if you want to rewrite something, unless, of course, you're going to rewrite it via sheet music. But that still makes it very structured, whereby we don't work in a structured way. We can speed songs up, slow them down, change them accordingly, sometimes not through choice, but But it's just how we feel. I mean, we had a gig last Friday when it was a dinner dance and we were to play quite slow stuff just in the background music while they're eating. So maybe some of our even faster songs, we could slow down, whereby if you don't listen and you don't have that ability, it's quite difficult because you've learnt it one way and that's the way you generally play it every single time. But we can mix it up subject to what's going on at the time. So,
well, 2 ears and one mouth, use them in that ratio.
Yes. Yeah.
When Pete, you first said that your country and Deb said she was more rock and roll, do you know what popped into my head?
Go on.
Bloody Donnie and Marie. Being a little bit country and I'm a little bit rock and roll. And that's definitely not what you are. You're not Donnie and Marie.
She wasn't saying we are.
No.
No. It's just the soul.
I was going to say, this interview is terminated.
Pete, you started playing at 16, your guitar. Debbie, when did you start playing?
A little bit later than that. I was 50. So, yeah, again...
Except 2 years ago.
Yeah, exactly. yes, just got ill, and I'd always wanted to play through the years, and the usual books that you get from the old record shops that used to be, old music shops that used to be, but it was all reading music, and it was something that, A, I didn't want to do, and B, because I didn't want to do it, I couldn't do it. So I thought that was the only way to play an instrument. And I'd only ever played by ear, but because I'd never been taught, I didn't, you know, it was just one finger sort of type stuff, which wasn't going to get you anywhere. So when I decided that I'd give it one last go, I found a music teacher, and fortunately, he said that I didn't have to play my music. So, and he just taught me. And it just kind of went from there, really. And from that, I then met or saw in the local music shop that was then, that's now since sadly gone, like so many have, there was an advert in there for this group at South Hill Park that Pete mentioned earlier. And that's what I went along to. And they met Pete and it just again evolved. So
Pete, what did you think when this wayward wild woman walked in with her guitar?
Well, you know, the night that Debs first came to the group, to the South of Park, was a night where the guy who usually runs it, so which is a guy named Russ, who's he's a brilliant guy. We don't really hate you, Russ, if you're going to watch this.
He's great.
He was away, so he'd asked me to run the group, and Debs turned up and sang. And I remember afterwards saying to her that she had a voice that was recordable because it was different. So that was my first, you know, the first time I'd heard Debs perform. And yeah, she did. She had a great voice.
Well, you remember what?
No, that was back then. Well, Pete said that he also said that, you know, because obviously I was as nervous as hell. I'd never played in front of anybody at all and was still very, very new to the guitar and singing anyway. And Pete sort of said, you know, you'll just need to learn to sing out. And with that, I then went and had a couple of singing lessons to overcome my nerves. Because that's, I found playing the guitar in front of people very nerve-wracking. I found singing even more so, because that's very personal when it's your voice and that. And like a lot of people, you can sing in the shower, but to actually stand in front of even just one person is a completely different ballgame. And from then on, out of that group, with both Russ, obviously, Pete, that goes without saying, and a couple of others, I mean, the influence and the hand-holding to improve and move forward was just phenomenal. I mean, it was just an amazing, I couldn't, no money could buy that.
A supportive for me. Group, wasn't it?
Very supportive, very supportive. But the level of musicianship that was there in both Russ, a guy named Tom, And obviously Pete, I mean, those three alone, I couldn't buy that experience and the fact they were so patient and all inclusive. And that's really the nuts and bolts of Be Fine, the band that we were in to start with. Mm-hmm. It was just an overwhelming experience the first time I was amongst them, because it was like climbing a mountain, albeit that they were at the top of the mountain with their hands all down saying, come on up, Deb. But I mean, obviously the level that they were at and the level that I were at were not even in the same league. I mean, just way, way, way. But it was amazing how it all came together, and gradually we played together, we performed together, we did several different gigs. We played the Bracknell Beer Festival, yeah, and that was in front of 3,000 people. So, that went from just playing to amongst us all to suddenly having that sort of audience. So it was incredible.
That was a five-piece band we put together, which was mostly people from the South Hill Park.
That was a brilliant show. I saw that.
You did.
And we called the band Be Fine because it'll be fine. Don't worry about it. It'll be fine.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So can we have a little taster of you as Union Blue?
Okay. Well, Deb's hasn't got a guitar here, so we'll do one that is just one guitar. Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted one time to see you laughing. Only wanna see you laughing in the purple rain. Purple rain, purple rain. Never wanna be your weekend lover. Only wanna be some kind of friend. I could never steal you from another. It's just a shame that our friendship had to end. Purple rain,
love it. I've missed hearing you sing. That's brilliant.
We went a bit of a gap, didn't we? I think we did a festival in August last year, and then the first gig we did after that was last Friday.
Yeah.
This COVID's not really good for anybody, is it?
No, but it hasn't taken your voice away and it hasn't taken your talents away, so that's something to be grateful for.
Yeah,
which I am, and I think everyone that we're watching this will be. Oh, sorry, did I lose you then?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, just a little bit of a freeze.
Yeah.
was just saying, just grateful that you're still playing and singing is wonderful. So how was the gig last week? To be back in front of everyone.
It was like we'd never been away.
It was. It was just like old times. It really, we had one on the Friday and then we played at Ascot Farmers Market on Sunday for their 20th anniversary. And both went down very, very well. So excellent.
It's, I think it's a bit like seeing old friends, you know, you don't forget. It's always, you know, it's always in your mind. So when you do get back together, it doesn't take very much to pull it back again.
Yeah.
So what have you both got planned for Union Blue moving forward or individually as musicians?
Is this the time to announce the breakup?
Yeah.
No, not really.
I think is, it's fair to say that we've never had a plan.
We don't have a plan.
Yeah, we've just never set out all the gigs that we've ever done have been, we've been asked to do them rather than we've gone knocking on people's doors. You know, we're both now retired. And so obviously there's other things going on in our lives with that.
We're grateful. We're grateful for the exposure that we get, for the opportunities we get, and they spin off into other things. And Deb said we did the farmers market on Sunday, which is a busking gig really. But from that came two opportunities, one at a vineyard and one at a festival in Swallowfield. Regrettably, we can't do the Swallowfield one because we're both busy. But yeah,
so it's, are they really open to everyone, or are they private gigs?
The
vineyard's going to be a private function. It's not a public vineyard, so it is by invite only. So they do have some functions. What that actually is, I don't know. But she's got our details and got us on the books, and we'll be in touch as and when, sort of thing.
The Swallowfield we can't do because the dates clash. So
yeah,
which is unfortunate because that seems like a good gig. But there we are. It happens.
Yeah. And then we're in Southill Park playing at the Food Festival.
And Music Festival. Southill Park Arts Centre in Bracknell has a food and music festival over the bank holiday. And I think they've got music on 3rd, 4th and 5th. That's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And we're playing on the Saturday at 2, 3 o'clock?
At 2:30.
Yeah, 2:30. Yeah. And it's
so
it's a free
2:30.
Free food.
2:30
Saturday
the
4th.
I'll make sure I put all the dates and times at the end of our interview. I've just had a flash up on my thing saying our time is running out, so we've got a little bit of time left. But what I normally do with my guests is I have a quick fire round. So you've got to think fast, Deb. Can you do that?
Oh dear. Yeah, go on then, I'll do my best. All right. It takes a while to get the old cogmatic working, but go on.
Right, so what we'll do is I've got my questions and you just take it in turns to answer the questions rather than answering the same one. Okay, so who wants to go first?
Yeah, go on, Pete's gonna answer the first one then.
All right, Pete, the last film you watched.
Last film I watched.
This is a quick fire round. Take your time.
Sorry. I'm glad you got that because
I'm really not big on
movies. We don't watch films.
I turn it on its head. We've been binging Bosch. Have you heard of Bosch?
Bosch, no. What's that about?
Yeah, it's a cop drama thing on Prime.
Oh,
Prime.
Okay.
Yeah.
On Netflix, is it?
Prime, Amazon Prime.
Okay. Debs, favourite colour?
Blue.
Blue. What's your favourite takeaway?
Indian.
Indian. Debbie, beach or countryside?
Countryside.
Pete, do you prefer London or Paris?
London.
And last one, Debbie. Are you a little bit country or a little bit rock and roll?
A little bit rock and roll. But not Marie.
Not Marie.
Yeah, not right.
You've got your album, Union Blue. Do you have any copies left that people can contact you on Instagram or Facebook?
You certainly can. I always say it was a million seller, but what I really mean is we've got a million left in the cellar. But yeah, we've got a fair few.
Yep, yeah.
Because of course, albums are old hat now, aren't they? It's all Spotify and all that sort of stuff. So, which we haven't done yet. So perhaps that'll be our next move, is to get it up on a platform somewhere.
And also, we released it in January 2020, where we all knew what happened 2 months later. So
it wasn't great timing.
It wasn't good planning.
There's such a wide range of songs on there. There is absolutely something that everyone, I mean, I love the whole album. I play it in my studio when I'm painting. I don't know if anyone catches any of my lives when I'm doing live painting. You're in the background. So I don't know if I'm supposed to pay you a fee or not, but I haven't.
Don't worry, it's been noted.
Yeah.
What's your favourite song? Last question for both of you. What's your favourite song on that album?
Radioactive.
I would say Dixie for me. The night they drove old Dixie down. I do like Radioactive as well. I like them all, but yeah.
Thank you so, so much for joining me today. And this will be, I'll let you know when this is going to be posted out. It's not going to be next week, it'll be the week after. I'm going to post this out for everyone to watch and get to see a bit of you. I'm going to be putting the links to the bank holiday show that you're going to be doing at the Bracknell Arts Centre. I will put the link to your Instagram and Facebook pages. Are they up to date by chance?
What's Instagram?
Yeah, I was going to say, what's on that then?
Facebook's not too bad. Yeah. Instagram, well, no, not good.
Yeah.
All right. I'll put the link to your Facebook page.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. That'd be great, give you a clue.
Do we look like people that are into that sort of stuff?
We've mastered the art of the carrier pigeon, though.
thank you so much for joining me today. I'll see you again soon.
Absolutely. Take care, Sammy. Thank you.
Bye. Bye. Oh, I just need to stop recording. What has he got?